大家好，在今天的视频里，我们将会跟大家讲一些个生活中的言谈举止怎么用英语来表达。所以我们请麦克老师跟我们一起讲一下地道的英语怎么说。
大家好，我是麦克老师。
So you're going to teach us how to say body language in a proper English?
Yeah, we'll talk about some body language today and, you know, how we look at people, how we, you know, interact with people.
如果你们觉得我们的频道对你有价值，没有订阅的，欢迎大家订阅，然后脚上有一个二维码可以资助我们。我们现在开始啊，先说看人。我们都知道最简单的就是我们看一个人就是 I look at him。但是如果你想表达你很全神贯注的在看一个人，说我不是随意的看你，这个怎么说呢？
I look directly at her. I looked.Directly at her. I looked directly at her.
在这里头，这个虽然 directly 是直接的意思，但是在这儿表达的更是一种，我的这个整个注意力吧，都在你的身上。
So directly is not just indicates the direction, also indicates the focus as well.
Yeah, so when you talk about directly looking at someone, it's, you know, we're not kind of sort of looking at them, we're, you know, having a conversation and looking around, but when you're like directly focused on them, you look directly at someone and focus on them.
Oh, 在这儿就讲的不是说只是随随便便的那种很放松的那种随便的看。那怎么说我目不转睛的盯着他看。
I never took my eyes off her. I never took my eyes off her.
Took eyes off 就是把你的眼睛转向别处了，看到别处了。我直视着他的眼睛，就是说我一下子看到了他的心底，这种怎么说？
I looked into her eyes.I looked into her eyes. I looked into her eyes.
我眼睛朝下看，我朝下看。
I looked down. I looked down. I looked down.
我眼睛朝别处看了，我不再看这个。东西或者人了。
I looked away. I looked away. I looked away.
如果一个人把他眼睛看到别处呢，实际上他是在躲避和你的交流。那我如果想说他故意躲避我的眼光。故意躲避我的目光。
She avoided eye contact with me. She avoided eye contact with me. She avoided eye contact with me.
Avoid 是躲避的意思。Eye contact 指的是人眼睛和眼睛这种目光的接触。那如果两个人四目相对，眼睛对视了，这个怎么表达？
Our eyes locked. Our eyes locked. Our eyes locked.
Lock 在这儿本身是锁的意思，在这儿呢就是两只眼睛像锁一样被锁住了。另外呢Look 还有不同的表达方式，除了说在看，它还有说这个人看起来怎么样的意思。比如说，他看起来很快活。
She looked pleasant. She looked pleasant. She looked pleasant.
我点了点头。
I nodded. I nodded.I nodded.
如果说我朝她点了点头。
I nodded at her. I nodded at her. I nodded at her.
当我们这样向别人示意的时候，可能那个人原来和我们不熟的一个人呢，他就更放得开了，这个人就放松了，不那么拘谨了。怎么说？
She became more animated. She became more animated.She became more animated.
大家看麦克老师一下子就变得很活跃了。我们知道 animate 是跟 animal 这个词大家都知道啊，有关系的啊，哎，就变成非常活跃了。那我们说如果一个人的话他很不能动了或者怎么样，我们就说是植物人哈，那个就是 vegetable， 从那个词来的啊。在下面呢，他一直都对我微笑。
She smiled at me the whole time. She smiled at me the whole time. She smiled at me the whole time.
后是整个的意思啊。我向前欠了欠身子，或者说倾了倾身子。
I leaned forward. I leaned forward.I leaned forward.
Lean 呢，就是这个人哈，朝一个方向倾斜的意思。但是我可以像，比如说，倾斜的时候靠了一个人，就是我要摔倒了，我靠住了他。
She leaned against me. She leaned against me. She leaned against me.
如果我看见一个人呢，坐在我不远的地方，我就朝他那儿欠了欠身子，然后这个抓住了他的手。
She leaned forward and took my hand. She leaned forward and took my hand. She leaned forward and took my hand.
麦克斯老师用他的第一人称的口气说的这句话啊，他讲的是。我朝前倾了倾身子，然后抓住了他的手。在下面一个大家注意啊，是我跟我们的中文哈，习惯不太一样的一种说法。比如说，一个人他这个朝我的胳膊打了一下。
She punched me in the arm. She punched me in the arm. She punched me in the arm.
我们中文里哈没有说还有中间有个的呀或者这些这么复杂，我们中文会说他打了我的胳膊。所以我想问一下麦克老师，我们如果直接这样说可不可以呢？ So Mike, in our culture we don't have this complicated format. We say she punched my arm. Is that okay to say that?
It is okay to say that andprobably even easier to say that because、
yes.
when we say she punched me in the arm that'll work and so would it work as well if you said she punched me in the stomach but it wouldn't work in some cases like she kissed me in the cheek I mean we don't kiss in the cheek we kiss on the cheek so if we're to leave that part out it could be even easier to just say she punched my arm or she punched my stomach or she kissed my cheek
他解释说呀，直接这样那样说，在英语里也是说得通的。就是哎，他打了我的肚子，打了我的胳膊。在这儿有一点非常重要，如果你用那种比较复杂的形式说哈 ，She punched me in my arm。这里面 ，Oh, actually, I realized, I always say she punched me in my arm or in my stomach. You're more like.She punched me in the stomach. You used the.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's... I mean, you wouldn't be wrong to say she punched me in my arm. It's just we tend to usually say in the arm.
Oh, 还有一点大家要注意的是，如果你说我打了那个人的肚子一下哈，你要说 the 那个肚子前面那个冠词， 正常的用 the， 不是按我们习惯用我的。看来呀，我们这个言谈举止啊，是让人看起来非常的舒服啊，还是不舒服啊，关系还挺大的。所以我想问一下麦克老师，在英文里面他们是怎么看待这个身体语言的？ So Mike, how do you look at body language in communicating with people?
Well, I think that's 90% of communication is body language, and maybe the other 10% actually what we're saying. But, you know, we look at the way people say stuff and the way they hold themselves, and that really, you know, gives a lot more information than the words themselves, you know. And we've got different types of body language, like we've got negative body language where someone's always like,you know, like upset, and you know, maybe they're slouching a bit or like crossing their arms or something, you know, and very closed. And then we have you know, very positive body language where people are like, you know, very open and you know, they're happy and very expressive, and you know, these convey different messages. And you might be saying the same thing but with different body language, it could be interpreted very differently.
麦克老师刚才在讲啊，我们身体所表达出来的这种信息，他管它叫身体语言，比我们嘴上传递出来的，实际上在和人交流的时候传递的信息更多更重要。那些个凡是让人感到很拘谨的、很紧张的，你自己也不愿意跟别人真正表达的那种身体语言，叫做 negative body language。那些个让别人能够敞开心扉，比如说你面带微笑啊，他管那些个叫做 positive body language。所以看起来哈，我们应该怎么表达自己的身体语言呢？是非常重要的一件事情。我非常谢谢麦克老师今天给我们做这些讲解。So Mike, thank you so much for do the explanations. You did it in a very vivid way.
Well, thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure, and I look forward to doing the next one. And I'd also like to thank everyone for those very nice comments that you've been leaving. Thank you very much. And I read them, and yeah, it's very nice to see those comments. So thank you very much, everybody.
麦克老师他对大家对他的这些肯定啊、赞扬啊感到很感谢啊。我也很高兴。如果大家觉得我们的频道对你有价值，没有订阅的欢迎订阅，然后我们脚上有一个二维码，如果想资助我们频道的呢，可以扫描资助我们。咱们下次见。